Next event is the Sheraton Washington Hotel. Number six. Home on the camera, wouldn't on recorder.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan.
The weather the way it was, we were afraid nobody'd come. Well, it's just an opportunity to thank you all very much. Not only for here and for being here and all, but for what you've done to make it possible for us to have this kind of a few days here in Washington. The inaugural ball is quite a tradition. The first one was held in New York a week after George Washington had become president. And I like to tell that at the time, Mrs. Washington wasn't there. She was in Virginia packing. That was kind of one of the nice things about doing it for the second time, because we only had to unpack. And then in 1829, Andrew Jackson held the inaugural ball in the East Room of the White House. And you know Andy's friends. And they had a kind of potent punch. And before the evening was out, the only way he could escape was out through one of the White House windows. He bailed out. Teddy Roosevelt, when his inaugural ball was held, the song of the evening was, "There'll be a hot time in the old town tonight." I wish on this particular day that we could have said the same thing. But I think there is a warm glow in the town tonight. And we're very grateful to you. We thank you very much, and I've been sort of slipping some information out here. I can't give you the exact details because it's boycotted until tomorrow, or embargoed, I should say, until tomorrow morning. But I can tell you that in view of what the stock market did today, which we do know, for those who don't know what we're talking about, it was the eighth biggest single increase in a day's increase. The eighth in history. That's right. But tomorrow morning, two more pretty potent economic figures will be released. Can't tell you what they are. I can only tell you that one of them will be the best since 1967. And the other will be the best since 1951. The only thing we still have around are those pessimists that said that the program wouldn't work, and now they're saying it won't last. Well, they were wrong the first time, and they're wrong the second time. We really ain't seen nothing yet. Thank you all very much.
Mr. President, may I ask you on behalf of this crowd to lead this ball in a dance with your wife, Mrs. Reagan.
Thank you. We just wanted to come by and say another heartfelt thank you to all of you for all that you did to make this possible. And for being here tonight now to help along with the whole thing. I knew that I couldn't just spend all my time saying thank you, although I like you, I feel that way. So I thought I'd just bring along a couple of news notes. And that is that, you probably heard about the stock market today. Now, just to round it out, for all those pessimists that said that we couldn't make it work, and now the same pessimists say, well, okay, so it worked, but it won't last. You're wrong then, they're wrong now. And tomorrow morning, I can't tell you the figures, they're embargoed until tomorrow morning, but I can tell you this. Two more economic figures will be released tomorrow. And one of them will be the best since 1967. And the other will be the best since 1951.
Yeah, we just finished the Shoreham Hotel. Now we're heading on to the signal here.
Like a shadow. President of the United States.
Thank you all for what you've been doing over quite a long period of time, and then another heartfelt thank you for being here for this celebration. You know, with the weather that hit us and caused some changes, sadly enough, I couldn't help but think that if the pilgrims had come here by way of that other ocean, the capital would have been in California. Anyway, the first inaugural ball was held in New York, and it was a week after George Washington had become president, and I like to tell that Mrs. Washington at the time wasn't there. She was in Virginia packing. Of course, this morning after we signed in, why, we went up and unpacked. Then there was Andrew Jackson's, and his was in the East Room of the White House in 1829. And the party got so raucous with the punch that he served that he had to bail out a White House window to do it to escape. Teddy Roosevelt was dancing to "There'll Be a Hot Time in the Whole Town Tonight." I wish we could say that. Thank you. Well, listen, thank you all very much.
The President!
Have a good time.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay.
Mrs. Reagan.
The President, my shake
your hand. Down.
Mrs. Reagan.
The President, you shake your hand.
I don't think we can make it without crushing.
No.
I'll tell you what I think we ought to do instead. Shouldn't we start the dancing?
Yeah. Hey, Michael!
Are they gonna switch?